Good morning, and welcome to our annual service of lessons and carols. A special welcome to those who are tuning in live by video stream, or may be watching this later on by video recording. We're glad that you have joined us today in our Chapel of the Atonement as we continue to mark the holiday season. Dear people of God, in this Advent season, it is our responsibility and joy to prepare ourselves to hear once more the message of the angels, to go to Bethlehem and see the Son of God lying in a manger. Let us hear and heed in Holy Scripture the story of God's loving purpose from the time of our rebellion against Him until the glorious redemption brought to us by His holy child, Jesus. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of His birth with hymns and songs of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of this whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the church for which He died, and especially for His church in our country and in this city. Because He particularly loves them, let us remember in His name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and unloved, the aged and little children, as well as all those who do not know the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Finally, let us remember before God His pure and holy Mother, and that whole multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in Jesus we are one forevermore. And now to sum up all these petitions, let us pray in the words which Christ Himself has taught us, known as the Lord's Prayer, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Almighty God bless us with His grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life. To the fellowship of the citizens above, to the King of angels, bring us all. Amen. Thank you.
A reading from the book of Genesis 3, 1 through 15. Now the serpent was made more subtle than any other wild creature that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say, 'You shall not eat of any tree from the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the tree of the garden, but God said, 'You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die.'" But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and that they were naked. And they sewed figs together and made themselves aprons. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And man and his wife hid themselves in the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called out to man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of thee in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself." God said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree which I commanded you not to eat?" And the man said, "The woman who thou gavest to be with me, she gave me the fruit of the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord said to the woman, "What is it that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are all you above all cattle, and above all wild animals. Upon your belly you shall go, and thus you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and he shall be bruised his heel." Here ends the reading.
Gospel of Isaiah, chapter 40, verses 1 to 11. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and cry to her that her worker is ended, that her iniquity is pardoned, that she has received from the Lord's hand double all her sins. A voice cries, and the wilderness prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry. And I said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all its beauty is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people is grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of the God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem. Herald of good tidings, lift it up, fear not. Say to the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arm. He will carry them in his bosom, and gently lead those that are with him. Here ends the reading.
to our king who belongs to the clan of Judah. For he shall come forth to me, one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall bring them up until the time when she, whom Israel, has brought forth. Then the rest of his brethren shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and be the flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty, the name of the Lord his God. And they shall dwell secure. For now he shall be great to the end of the earth. Here ends the reading.
God's word for you, Miss Whitman. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How shall this be, since I have no husband?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God." Here ends the reading.
suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among them of whom he is pleased." And the angels went away from them into heaven. The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in the manger. Here is the
they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy, and going into the house, they saw the child and his mother. And they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to accept Mary, they departed to their own country by another way. Here it is to you.
Upholding the universe by his word.
of power. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has obtained is more excellent than theirs. For to what angel did God ever say, "Thou art my son, today I have begotten thee"? Or again, "I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son"? And again, when he brings the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all God's angels worship him." Of the angels, he says, "Who makes his angels winds, and his servants flames of fire?" But of the Son, he says, "Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. The righteous scepter is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. Therefore God, thy God, has anointed thee with the oil of gladness beyond thy comrades. And thou, Lord, didst found the earth from the beginning, and the heavens are the work of thy hand. They will perish, but thou remainest. They will all grow old like a garment. Like a mantle thou wilt roll them up, and they will be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years will never end." Here ends the reading.
Please stand and join us in hymn number 111.
Thank you.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things are made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came for testimony to bear witness of the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness to the light. The true light that enlightens every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world knew him not. He came to his own home, and his own people received him not. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of men, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have beheld his glory, glory of the only Son from the Father. John bore witness to him and cried, "This is he of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks before me, for he was before me." And from his fullness have we all received grace upon grace. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only Son, who is in the bosom of the Father, he has made him known. Here ends the reading.
Please stand and join us in number 100, going to the Lord.
Thank you.